Hey guys, I am Chef Pratima Sood and we will be making a really quick recipe today. I will just wait for some more people to join in so that then I will introduce myself, run you all through the ingredients and we can begin with the recipe. I hope I'm audible and clear. Please give me a thumbs up if I'm clear. Hi Pushpalata, hi Rakesh, hi Nisha. So guys, during the session, if you guys have any queries, y'all can have them coming in on the comment section below. And once I am done giving y'all the demo, I will start taking the questions and reverting to the queries. Also, by the end of the session, I will have a complete recipe that will go up on my Instagram and Facebook page. Y'all can find it over there tomorrow. So in the meantime, y'all can check other recipes out over there. I have the description, the link, just the description. Okay, so now enough people have joined in. I'll quickly introduce myself and I'll tell you all what we're making today, run you all through the ingredients. So guys, I am Chef Pradhima Sood. For those of you who have been watching lives with Amul from a long time, you all must be aware that I have been hosting quite a few live sessions with Amul. And I've literally taken this up after a very long gap today. So I run a business in Bombay by the name Low Home Bistro, where I take orders for cakes and DIY savory stuff. Now, without further ado, let's skip to the recipe. We are making a creamy mushroom toast today. So a creamy mushroom is a really quick recipe with very few ingredients. So I'll just run you all through it. I have everything ready here. So I'm taking about 2 cups of Amul milk, which I've already measured out. And I'm taking about 1 whole pack of mushrooms. That's about 200 grams. I've thinly sliced it, as you all can see. And I'm going to be using cheese slices by Amul. I'm using 6 of them. And I'm going to be using basic spices. And I'm going to be using oats flour. Okay. So we'll quickly begin with the recipe. Just give me a second, guys. Since my tripod is not big enough, I'll have to put things on the pan and then show it to you all. So first of all, I'm adding Amul butter. I'm taking about a tablespoon of it and I'm going to add that and heat that. Once it begins melting, I'm going to add in 1 tablespoon of oats flour and then I will show you all what I'm doing. Now my butter has melted, I'm just adding 1 tablespoon of oats flour and then I will give you all a quick look at the pan. So here I'm measuring out 1 tablespoon. Y'all could use anything, y'all could even add refined flour or whole wheat flour or any other flour of choice. I prefer oat flour because it gives a nice earthy flavor and nutty flavor to your dish. Let me just show you all the pan, I've not started mixing yet. So that's my flour and butter, I'm going to just mix it quickly. So over here, this is something very similar to how you make your white sauce, but this is going to be more of a sauce with oats and cheese, and we're going to add mushrooms towards the end. Y'all can also add in any other vegetables, probably y'all could caramelize some onions and y'all could add some chopped green bell peppers or mixed bell peppers to it, that would be fine too. So now this has mixed, this has turned slightly light brown if y'all can see. Can you all see the texture? So at this stage, I'm going to add in the milk a little by little and keep mixing it so that we have no lumps. Just give me a second. I'll have to put my phone aside. Just going to keep adding in the milk little by little. Just going to pour a little in. And then I'm going to just mix it so that we don't have any lumps there. At this stage, y'all can preferably use a whisk in your pans. So that eases out the process and makes it faster. I'm using a regular spatula because that helps me blend in everything really well. and it helps me break down lumps if there are any. So I'm gonna add in rest of the milk now, and then I will continue whisking it till we get a nice boil. So I'm just going to go bring my whisk. So now let me just show this to you. This is 2 cups of Amul milk, 1 tablespoon butter and 1 tablespoon of oats flour. I'm just going to whisk it so that it's nice and smooth. You all can add refined flour, whole wheat flour or any other flour of choice. Oats flour is a very good gluten-free option for all those who are on a gluten-free diet. I'm just going to read through some comments now. Meantime, this will come to a boil. Okay, so there aren't any really questions on the comment section. You guys have any queries so far? Geeta Bhel, the camera is towards the pan itself. Can you see the dish right now? So as you all can see that this is incorporated really well. I'm just going to leave it till it comes to a boil now. I'm going to stop whisking it there. So you're supposed to add mushrooms towards the end. If at all y'all are adding things like caramelized onions or capsicum, y'all could add that in once this comes to a boil. But y'all could also add that in earlier, and like y'all could cook it separately, cook the sauce separately and mix it in, no issues. But I would suggest to add the mushrooms directly into the sauce towards the end, as it gets a really, really nice texture. And we add it towards the end because mushrooms take really, you know, less time to cook. I hope I am audible enough to you guys. So in between, just keep whisking it a little so that it doesn't stick down. You have to make sure that this doesn't burn or stick. Okay, so Lena, I am making a creamy mushroom sauce which I will be topping on top of a toast. And to do that, I have heated 1 tablespoon of butter with 1 tablespoon oats flour, and I've added 2 cups of Amul milk. Okay, so now at this stage, I'm just gonna add in my spices. One second. Give me a second, guys. So I'm not using much. I am just adding some pepper, mixed herbs and salt. I'll just add about a teaspoon of pepper. Adding salt to taste. I'm gonna add in mixed herbs. So I'm using 6 Amul cheese slices over here. You all could use as per your choice or taste. So that's it. I've added pepper, mixed herbs and salt. I'm gonna whisk that in again. For those who have joined late, don't worry. This video is gonna be up on the Amul page for a long time. And you all could also go to the links in the description and find these recipes on my Instagram page. I will be posting this recipe in a detailed form tomorrow. So I've whisked the spices in. and the milk has nearly boiled. So at this stage, I'm gonna add in about 2 to 3 slices of cheese slices already. Let me just do this. 1 second. So I am doing nothing. If y'all don't have Amul cheese slices available, y'all can take Amul cheese cubes. Y'all can use about 4 of them. Y'all can grate it and use it. Y'all can also use Amul mozzarella dice blend for this. I'm just gonna like break it up like this and I'm gonna start adding it in. So Amul has a variety of cheese available. They have a cheese sauce, they have a cheese spread. So whatever kind of cheese you have on hand, you can go ahead and use that. I love using cheese slices because they are quite thin and they melt away super easily. So you know, if you are short on time and you don't have the time to sit and grate a cube or something, you can just break this up like this into tiny bits and you can go ahead and add it in. So I've added 2 cheese slices so far. I'm just going to quickly whisk that. And I will show you all as well. I've added 2 in here. I'm just going to quickly whisk it. So as we add cheese, we have to make sure that we are continuously stirring or whisking so that it doesn't really stick or burn and we get the right consistency that we are looking for. Once 2 slices melt away, I will add the rest of them in. Also, we have to reduce this mixture while cooking. Y'all can see when I had added 2 cups of milk, it was still almost top of the pan and now we are nearly at half of it. We have to further reduce this. I'm just gonna add in 2 more cheese slices now. Do y'all have any queries so far? I'm just gonna break it up like this into tiny pieces randomly and I'm just gonna keep adding that in. So I've added another 2 slices now. I will just give this a quick mix. To check the consistency, I will show it to y'all on back of the spatula so that y'all understand how thick is it actually supposed to be. So other 2 slices have melted away as well. I'm just adding the last 2 slices of cheese and then we'll carry on with the further process. The reason I'm adding cheese by 2 slices, it's on medium flame. It's the only reason I'm adding cheese slice by slice because, you know, I don't want my cheese to stick or burn in the meantime. So just had 5 slices here. I'm quickly going to go bring out another slice. I'm just adding some extra cheese. Who doesn't love cheese? So I'm just adding some more of it. The more the cheese, the better it's gonna taste, the better. If you guys don't wanna add too much cheese, again, y'all can go ahead with adding about say 3 to 4 slices of cheese. And y'all can use Amul cream. Y'all can use 1/2 cup of Amul cream. But before y'all add the Amul cream to this, I would suggest y'all heat the cream in a small saucepan and then y'all add it in. Heat it to about lukewarm of temperature. Because if you all add cold cream to this, it will not blend well. This is really extremely hot right now. Your cream will split. You don't want your cream to split. You can see how this is forming a thick edge on the side. Can you all see? So this is what you're looking at when we say we have to reduce it on a medium flame. And keep mixing it so it doesn't stick down. Alright. So just give me a second there. I'm just adding all of my cheese slices. So I've added a total of 8 slices. I was gonna add 6, I've increased by 2 because I am not using Amul fresh cream for the recipe. But if you guys are, so as I said, for 4 slices of cheese, you all will use 1/2 cup of cream. And if you are adding 6 slices of cheese, you all will use 1/4 cup of Amul cream. So you all will substitute it accordingly. Cream will give a really nice smooth texture and a creamy texture. So you all can go ahead with using that. I'm done with adding all the cheese in. We're almost done with the sauce. So you can see how this incorporates really well. I'm just gonna stop whisking it. I'm just gonna get all the cheese off my whisk and then I'm gonna get back to my spatula. I'll show you all the consistency. Y'all can see how thick and creamy this is. So this is the consistency we are looking at. So also one more thing, guys, while cooking it, when I say you have to reduce it and make it thick, don't make it extremely thick when you remove it off the gas. I will show you all. Let it still be in a little liquid consistency because it has so much cheese and you're going to be adding in your vegetables or just the mushroom. While it sits and cools to room temperature or while you keep it in the fridge, it's going to thicken further. It's going to become hard, like how you keep butter. So butter at room temperature would be soft, but in the fridge, it's going to turn solid. So that's exactly what's going to happen to this because it has a lot of cheese. You can always reheat it in the microwave and use it. But yeah. Just keep stirring it so that it doesn't stick. Y'all can see we've reduced it nearly to a little less than 50%. We'll just reduce it a little more and then we can go ahead and add in our mushrooms. Just keep scraping your sides and keep whisking continuously. We don't want to waste anything and we don't want anything to stick or burn. Just give me a second, guys. Okay, so now I'll show you all the consistency. Can you all see? It's coating my spatula, right? So this is what we are looking at. Once you're here, see, it took a while to completely drip off. Can you all see that? So once we are here, we will add in the mushrooms now. Y'all can use whatever quantity. Since I am making complete mushroom sauce, I've used one whole pack of mushrooms. That's about 200 grams of it. So I'll just add that in. Give me a second. I'm just gonna lower the flame here so that my mixture doesn't stick down. This is the mushrooms I'm adding in, guys. I have cleaned them and thinly sliced them, as y'all can see. I'm just going to put that in. And I'm just going to mix this on a slow flame. I have lowered the flame right now. I'm going to mix this on a slow flame and then I will increase the flame after this. So now after adding the mushrooms, you have to cook it for further about, say, 2 to 3 minutes or at max 5 to 6 minutes, depending on the quantity of your mushroom. Mushrooms cook really fast. They'll start sweating and you will know when it's done. They'll also shrink in size, so you will know that they're done. So now that it's mixed in, I'm just gonna, you know, get my flame back to medium. Does anyone have any questions so far? So y'all can see how beautiful is that looking. I totally love the flavor of mushrooms, is why I don't add any other vegetable. But at this stage, y'all can already, like, once your mushroom is cooked, y'all can add in caramelized onions and cooked bell peppers. Y'all can cook them probably separately and add it in. Y'all can cook it in butter, y'all can cook it in oil or olive oil, and y'all can add whatever seasonings y'all want. I try keeping it minimal with mixed herbs and salt, pepper. Yes, Rinku, I have added raw mushrooms which were sliced, cleaned and sliced. They will cook inside the sauce itself. Always remember, keep stirring. This is a process, a little tedious process. You have to keep stirring continuously because you don't want your milk to stick down and become brown or caramelized and have a very weird flavor to your entire sauce. So I'm just gonna let this boil for a second. For those who've joined in late and are asking for the recipes in the comments, guys, this video is gonna stay up on the Amul page for a very long time. Anyways, I'll do a really quick recap. I'm making a creamy mushroom sauce, and for which I first heated about 1 tablespoon of butter and added 1 tablespoon of oats flour to it. I added oats flour because I really love the nutty flavor it gives. Y'all can go ahead with adding your maida, all-purpose flour, whole wheat flour, or choice of any other flour that y'all really like. Basically, the flour is going to give it a binding texture to your entire cream sauce and going to add to the flavor. So I chose oats. After that, once that was cooked, it became a little light brown. I added 2 cups of Amul milk and I let that reduce. So when I added the milk, my pan was full. Now my pan is a little less than half, so I had allowed my milk to reduce. Once my milk reduced to nearly 50%, I added salt, pepper and mixed herbs and whisked it in. Make sure that when you add the milk to the oats and butter mixture, you have to keep whisking continuously and you have to add your milk in small parts. You don't want any lumps in between. So to avoid any lumps, keep whisking when you add the milk initially. Once it comes to a boil, then you add in your mixed herbs, salt and pepper, and you mix that in. Once that comes to a boil, you start adding your cheese. So like I added cheese slices, I added 2 slices in, you know, breaks, because I didn't want my cheese or milk to stick down. So I quickly added 2, whisked it in and added 2 and so on. If you guys are using Amul cheese cube, I would suggest use 4 cubes for 2 cups of milk, grate it and add it to the mixture. If you guys are using Amul cheese spread, about 2.5 tablespoons to 2 cups of milk should also be good. If y'all are using the cheese sauce, then about, say, 3 to 4 tablespoons should be good for 2 cups of milk. If y'all are using the Amul mozzarella diced blend, then I would say 1/2 cup of that diced blend would be more than enough for 2 cups of milk. I hope I have answered all the queries. If y'all have any other questions, please leave them in the comments below. And don't worry, this video is going to be up on the Amul page for a long time. I'm going to post a complete detailed recipe on my Instagram and Facebook page by tomorrow. Y'all can find the links to my pages in the description below. So y'all can see this has started to bubble up. We are nearly done with cooking this. Just keep scraping your sides and mixing in every 2 minutes. We don't want anything to burn. Y'all can see the mushroom is actually shrinking. So this is a great sign of knowing that you are reaching at your desired consistency. if you are adding pre-cooked caramelized onions, I would suggest once you are finished with your entire cooking process, then you can just mix it in because those are already pre-cooked and they don't require any cooking. Plus, if you add that while on flame, it might lose on its actual flavor that it's going to give. Yes, Sonia, oats is a healthy alternative to maida. Like I said, it's not just an healthy alternative, but it also provides a really nice nutty and creamy texture. So if you actually use oats in place of maida for any of your white sauces or any of your pastas for that matter, you will see drastic results in taste and it will be much better than the kind of after result that maida would give. We just have to let this cook till it further reduces. Again, if you guys are not using so much cheese and you all are going to add in cream, make sure that you guys are heating your cream till it's lukewarm and then adding it in. If you add cold cream to hot milk, it will split. Please make a note of these tiny things because some people end up adding cold cream to hot milk and then it splits. Even if your cream is room temperature, you will have to heat it till it's lukewarm and then mix it in. And for 2 cups of milk, like I said, you will take about 2 tablespoons of cream or 1/2 cup of cream, which will depend on the quantity of the cheese that you're taking. So you will have to substitute as per the quantities that you take for your cheese. I have not added any cream, so I've used 8 cheese slices. Okay, so now I am just gonna get this off the flame. Okay, and I'm going to transfer it to a bowl. Just give me a second, guys. It's almost boiled. I'm just going to clear the area a little bit so that I can add this in. Said we want it to be at a little liquid consistency when we get it off the flame. That is because by the time this cools down to room temperature, it is going to thicken further. So please don't think that you have to completely 100% thicken it out on the flame. Please don't do that. So here I've added everything to a bowl. I will just give you all a quick look at it. This is the creamy mushroom sauce. Okay. And once this cools down to room temperature, you all can simply just heat a toast in a toaster or on the pan. And instead of putting butter, you all can directly put this mixture on the toast and have fun with it. It's a really quick snack, really quick breakfast. Another thing you all can do is, you all can take the bread slice. You all can cut it into 4. So you'll get 4 tiny squares. And you all could just toast that up on the pan. And once that is done toasting, you can put this up and probably you can add a little more grated cheese on top and put it in your oven till the cheese browns, and then you all can directly serve it to your guests for any parties or family get-togethers. It's a quick, great snack. I hope you guys enjoyed the recipe as much as I enjoyed making it for you guys. The video is gonna be up on the Amul page for a long time, so y'all can always keep coming back and keep watching. I'm also going to be putting up the detailed recipe on my Instagram and on my Facebook page tomorrow. So y'all can go follow me on Instagram and Facebook, and the links are in the description below. If y'all try out the recipe, do tag Amul India and do tag me. We'll be happy to see the creations. And someone's asked me, how do we add this to pasta? So if you're adding this to pasta, instead of making any other white sauce, you will directly just make this. You will reduce the quantity of cheese because you're looking at a saucy pasta. You don't want a mixture that's going to thicken over time. So you're just going to reduce the quantity of cheese and you're going to add in your boiled pasta to it and you're good to go. I hope you guys enjoyed. Do check my page out. This recipe will be up tomorrow, but in the meantime, y'all can find a lot of more interesting recipes on my page. Thank you guys for tuning in.